guys, welcome back to the channel. Thank you for coming back. So today on hoops, hoodies, and how to's, I'm going to show you how to get this look. I use two palettes for this look. One is the NSatiable palette and the other one is the Urban Decay Naked Heat palette to create this look. So you only need two palettes. However, a lot of the colors that are between these two you can find in other palettes as well. So if you want to see how I got this look, then keep on watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'm talking fast because my videos have been way too long and I need to cut them down. So see you in my next tutorial. Mwah. So after that dance break, we're gonna go ahead and get started. Who doesn't love a good dance break? Anyways, we're gonna start off with the transition color as always, and I'm gonna go in with the pencil brush first to mildly cut the crease. And then I'm going to go in with a Morphe blending brush. It doesn't have a number or name on it. And blend that out. And I'm going to alternate between brushes back and forth to intensify and deepen up that color. Next, I'm going to go in with that color from the Urban Decay Heat palette. And with the darker color to deepen up that crease just a little bit more. And I'm using the same two brushes, that pencil brush, and then going back in with the blending brush and blending it out seamlessly in the crease so there are no harsh lines. Next, I'm going to go in with an even darker color from the same palette, and I'm going to apply this on the outer V of my eye and then softly blend it into the crease. And then I'm going to go in with that blending brush from Morphe again and blend that out so there are no harsh lines. Next, I'm going to go in with a concealer brush and I'm going to put this all over my lid and cut out the crease area, and then I'm going to apply my lid color next. Next, I'm going in with this beautiful palette by NSatiables by Nika. You can find her on Instagram, and it's kind of like a pink shimmery color. And this is going to be my first lid color. Shade darker than that pink shimmer. It's still a shimmer, but it's just a shade darker, and I want to put that in between the outer V and the rest of my lid to kind of create a ombre transition from that light color into the darker crease color to make it all blend together. And next, I'm going to go in with that darker color that I used earlier, and I'm just going to pack on the outer V again to deepen it up a little bit more. I wanted it to be a little bit darker and apply a little bit more smoke, so that's why I'm going back in with that dark color. Next, I'm going to go in with that, it's kind of like a mix between a white and a gold shimmer, and I'm applying this one with my finger over top of that pink shimmer that I applied earlier to my lid space. And next, we're going to do eyeliner. I think this is my first video where I'm recording myself doing eyeliner. Oh my goodness, let me tell you, this took some time for me to get a sharp wing. Like, it took a lot of practice, and it's still a work in progress, but I can record now. So, and I'm using the NYX liquid liner. It gives me more control versus a gel liner. Next, I'm going to go in with a makeup remover wipe, and I only use this method, this technique, when I don't have any foundation on my face. Nothing else is on my face, so I can clean up that wing. If there's foundation on my face, then apply a concealer to sharpen up that line, and then you blend out that concealer. Next, I'm going to go in with the Hourglass number 28 serum over the dry patches of my face, which tend to be on my nose and around my cheeks and on my forehead. This doesn't happen. I don't need to use this all the time, but periodically I do get dry patches in those areas versus oily like I normally am, so I'll use that. Next, I'm going in with the MAC Prep and Prime Primer, and this is going to be my base before I put on my foundation. But before I put on my foundation, I need to sharpen up these edges. I need to blend out these edges because I didn't realize that they were looking crusty and fuzzy and looking a hot mess. So I had to cut the camera and go do that. Now I'm going in with the Tarte Smoothing Primer. And this works wonders for not emphasizing your pores and smoothing out the appearance of them. Doesn't take them away, but it's, you know, it minimizes the appearance of them. And another dance break. Oh my goodness. If I cut out the dance breaks, then I would finish my makeup a whole lot faster. Next, I'm going to go in with my favorite combination for my foundation, the Buxom Meet Me Latte Lightweight Foundation and the MAC Studio Fix Fluid in NC44. I apply the Buxom on the inner perimeter and the MAC on the outer perimeter and kind of create like a very, very, very mild contour. And I'm going to blend this out using a Makeup Addiction sponge. Next, I'm going to go in with my concealer. And I'm using the MAC Concealer in NC45. And I'm using a concealer brush to apply this. And then I'm going to use that same Makeup Addiction sponge, but just another side, to blend that out. Bronze and Warm Honey. I mix those two together to create my contour color. And then I'm going to, what I do is I use a Makeup Addiction sponge and I softly blend upward first and then I blend downward from my ear. I blend upward to emphasize my cheekbone area to create that depth for me, and then I blend downward from my ear to finish it up. I told y'all on my Instagram page, this was going to be nothing but silliness and goofiness and dancing, so I warned you. Next, I'm going to go in with my Warm Honey Concealer from LA Girl, and what I'm doing is I'm cutting out that contour with a liquid burst to blend it in with the rest of my face versus applying the Laura Mercier first, because that can be, for me, a little harsh and leave kind of like a cast. So I apply the concealer first, and then the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder next, and I don't bake, I just immediately wipe it off. Next, I'm going to go in with the Luscious Cosmetics, what is it called? matte drama. I think it's called matte drama palette. And I'm using those two darker colors. I'm doing two taps of the light, one tap of the dark to create that contour color that I want. And I'm setting all of the contour, the deep contour places on my face. Next, I'm going with that Makeup Revolution blush palette. And this was very new for me because if you've seen my previous videos, you know I'm not a real big fan of blush. And I usually stick to my Pacifica Beauty, which you'll see me switch to in this video coming up in a few seconds. Because I wasn't getting much of the color payoff from that blush palette. And I was too nervous to try any of the other colors. So I went back to my Holy Grail, Pacifica Beauty, and Tenderhearted and used that instead. And then right after blush, I'm going to go in with my favorite highlighter at the moment, which is by Makeup Revolution, and it's called Gold Addict. And oh my goodness, this color is gorgeous. And next, you will get to see my audition for American Idol. It's classic, you guys. Oh, won't you let me? Won't you help me? And I'm going to apply my MAC powder and I'm going to set the rest of my face. Next, I'm going to apply my Plum lip liner from MAC per usual. And then I'm going to apply my NYX liquid lip. And this was kind of a new color for me. It's like a berry-ish color, and I thought it matched my eyes really well. I will have all of the products that I mentioned in the bottom bar below for you. Next, I'm going to take a flat, I don't know if this is called a flat shader brush or flat liner brush. I can't remember. Anywho, it's flat. So I'm going to take that color and then Urban Decay Naked Heat palette that I used on my outer crease, and I'm going to put that in my lower lash line. And then I'm going to take that lighter color with a pencil brush and I'm going to blend that out. Next, I'm applying the Tarte Cosmetics Lights Camera Action, or no, Lights Camera Lashes. And I'm going to put this on my lower lash line for mascara. And I'm so upset because I don't think they make that anymore. Next, I'm going to go in with that white gold shimmer and I'm going to pop that on my inner corner. And then guess what, you guys? We are done. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. See you in my next tutorial.